Hello friends, welcome to our channel. This is Vasant Naik from Canara Engineering College. Today I will be discussing the basics of VHDL. Now let's start. What is VHDL? In this session I am going to discuss the main topics, that is, what is HDL, then five types of design units of VHDL. So before discussing what is HDL, five types of design units of VHDL are entity, architecture, configuration, packet declaration and packet body. We will come to this one later. Before that, we will discuss what is HDL. What is HDL? What is the need of HDL? HDL is nothing but hardware description language. So HDL is a hardware description language. So what is the use of hardware description language? Like we have seen the language C, C++, C, C++, .NET, Java, all these languages we use to write the program and manipulate the data in computer. These languages are called as software languages. Like this, we have so many components in digital hardware. Like the components are gates, like AND gate, OR gate, XOR gate, AND gate, OR gate, XOR gate, XOR gate, then NAND gate. Then we have other elements like flip-flops. In that we have SR flip-flops, we have JK flip-flops, we have D flip-flops. So suppose if I have a circuit which consists of hundreds of gates and flip-flops, then it's very difficult to draw the diagram and scale it in later stage. For that we need certain language which has got certain semantics that will describe the circuits. So such a type of language is called as hardware description language. So by this now you understood what is the need of hardware description language. So hardware description language allows a digital system to be designed and debugged at higher level before the implementation at gate and flip-flop level. So there are two most popular hardware description languages are VHDL and Verilog. So VHDL is a hardware description language that is used to describe behavior and structure of a digital system. VHDL stands for Very High Speed Integrated Circuit Hardware Description Language, or you can say like VESCA HDL or VHDL. So VHDL is a general purpose language. It is used to describe the digital hardware, and after describing the digital hardware, we can also simulate the operation of a wide variety of digital systems ranging from few gates to thousands of gates and other circuits. So students, you have to remember here some of the points related to VHDL before proceeding. So VHDL is a concurrent language, not like C, which is a sequential language. C is a sequential language, but VHDL is a concurrent language. And one more thing is VHDL is not case sensitive. So either you can write the program in uppercase or lowercase, and VHDL was designed to be technological independent. And one more thing you have to remember here is VHDL can describe a digital system at different levels. Those levels are called as behavior levels, data flow levels and structure levels. All these things we will discuss one by one with the example. Before discussing all these things, first let us see what is VHDL signal. So a Bayesian signal used to describe a signal in a physical system. For example, in this diagram, it's shown here. There are five VA signals are there. That is A, B, C, D, E. These are called as VHDL signals. So, and one more thing you have to remember here. The symbol in this case, symbol is, this symbol is called as assignment operator. Assignment operator means, for example, here the C is assigned with the value of A and B after 5 nanosecond, and signal E is assigned of value of C, E is assigned of value C or D after 5 nanosecond. So, a VHDL signal is used to describe a signal of a physical system. So, in the diagram, you have 5 signals, that is A, B, C, D, E, all these are signals. And behavioral description of the circuit, behavioral in the sense how the circuit works, this is described by here, E, that is E is assigned with the value which is computed by using D, word with the A and B. Now we will see the five design units in the VHDL, that is entity, architecture, configuration, package declaration and package body. It is found that most of the time we use entity and architecture. So in this session we will discuss about entity and architecture. Now what is entity? Now students will see first what is entity. Entity is used to specify input and output ports of a design and types of ports. So entity is used to define, or entity used to specify input and output ports and types of a port. For example, suppose I want to design a circuit with the X and Y input. So I want to design the circuit with X and Y input. This is the circuit, and I will give the name to the circuit. It is a circuit test, that is circuit used for testing. So now the output of this one is connected to two LEDs. That is, one is a LED one, other one is a LED two. So now in this, here I have defined input X and Y and output LED 1 and LED 2. That means when I give input X is equal to 1, then LED 1 should glow, and when I make Y is equal to 1, LED 2 should glow. That means I have defined X input and output without defining the function of the circuit. So I know what's my input to the circuit and what is the expected output. So this is called as entity. So entity is used to specify input and output ports and types of ports. For example, here X is input, Y is input, and LED 1 is output port and LED 2 is output port. Now, what is the architecture? Architecture describes or specifies the function of inside circuits. I told you, entity describes the input port and output port, but architecture describes how the circuit is going to work. For example, in the last diagram you have seen, to describe the entity, I need only input and output, but to describe the architecture, I need how this circuit works. For example, this circuit, when X is equal to 1, when X becomes 1, X is equal to 1, when X becomes 1, then this will going to connect LED 1. When Y is equal to 1, Y is equal to 1, this is going to connect LED 2. like this. So architecture defines how the circuit behaves or how the circuit works. Now we will see the typical VHDL design. The typical VHDL design consists of all these things. So here it starts with the declaration of libraries. This is the declaration of libraries. After that, this is common to all the designs. After that, the most important thing is entity. So here I have declared the entity like this. So you have to remember here, both entity and architecture as contain certain keyword and user defined word. In this case, the words represented in the blue colors are the keyword. For example, here this is the keyword entity, port, is, in, out, all these are keyword. And the word which is represented in black are user defined words. For example, library can also be user defined sometimes. So now here entity, I have given user defined words, that is LEDs, according to my simulation. And is, and port is used to define the input and output. So port starts with the round bracket and it end with the round bracket followed by end and LED name LEDs. So inside the port we have to declare that X and Y are type input and data type of standard logic. Now what is standard logic? Standard logic is a This standard logic is a library. This is a standard logic, is a library, and it is a part of this package. This is a part of this package. So similarly, LED 1 and LED 2 are the user defined word for the output, and it is a type of a output. It is a type of a output and data type of a standard logic, means the function of this is defined in this library. Similarly, we can define now architecture here. Architecture with the user defined word for the architecture is behavioral, that is it describes the function of a particular circuit and of LEDs. That is, I have to make sure I define the architecture for particular entity that I defined in my design. So please remember, any particular VHDL design can contain only one entity, and it can have, and several architecture can be mapped to this entity. So you have to make sure the particular architecture is mapped to that entity. So architecture statement starts with the begin and end followed by the statements. Here LED 1 and LED 2, as I explained in my earlier, the my circuit is something like I have two input X and Y and two output, that is LED 1 and LED 2. So when X is connected, or when X, suppose if you think X is a switch, when X switch X is connected, then LED 1 will glow, and or switch Y is connected, LED 2 will glow. So that's why I have assigned LED 1 with the value of X and LED 2 with value of Y. So please remember, both entities used to define input and output port, but architecture defines how the circuit is going to behave or how the circuit is going to work. This is very, very important. This is the typical VHDL design example. So the explanation of library we will see in the later session. So students, before winding up, we will see the entity declaration form and architecture declaration form once again. So in VHDL, to write complete VHDL module, we must declare input port and output port by using entity. So I told you entity is used to declare input and output port. So in this case, you can see here entity is declared, entity name of the entity two gates is, and followed by port declaration, that is port A B, sorry, that is A B D are input port in the diagram, A B D are the input port in the diagram, is, and of type data type bit, that bit means data type bit. There are several data types are there, so for timing, data type bit means it can take either value 0 or 1. So is a type output port or mode output port. So and data type belongs to bit, data type is a bit. Similarly, entity we should end with the once again end statement and entity name. Similarly, architecture, here you can see architecture with the name, and architecture belongs to particular entity, that is the entity name what we used here is 2_gate. Similarly, signal C of type bit. Here signal C is a internal signal, it is not it is inside this one architecture, it is not outside the this one, outside the design, it is inside the design, or it is internal signal. So internal signal we cannot define in entity, internal signal will define in architecture. So the value C is assigned with the A and B by using assignment operator, and E is assigned with the C or D by using a assignment operator. Similarly, so declaration form for entity is entity name is, and port declaration followed by entity end with the entity name, end with the entity name. So you can see here, so any VHDL program structure or any VHDL design can contain only one entity, but there can be several architecture that can be mapped to that entity. So diagram shows that one. Now architecture declaration form is something like this, architecture name, and this architecture belongs to particular entity name, followed by begin and end architecture. So in between architecture body, that is with the architecture body contains the like one structural statements, or it contains assignment statement, etc. We'll see how we can define architecture by using structural statements in the later stage. Thank you.